Welcome back, everyone. You have seen our next guest on just about every single Food Network show there is to be seen on. And today he is here making piping hot and puffy oven-baked pancakes, perfect for every occasion. Welcome back to our home, Chef Aaron May. Welcome
Thank
back.
Thank you for having me.
I couldn't be happier.
I mean,
I don't know where you find the time between all the shows and the three restaurants.
There's always time for pancakes.
Oh, there's always time.
That's what I think. Brunch.
For brunch.
Home and family.
There's always time for home and family. We appreciate
What's
that, Aaron.
Important?
Nothing's more important than here, than being here on our show, Aaron. That's joining right. Cam at the counter is Kimmy and Larissa. They're all very excited about these beautiful German pancakes. Now, this isn't a pancake, per se, like we're used to making at home. This is a pancake that you actually bake in the oven. Correct.
So normally you're used to using a griddle, right, and frying up pancakes.
Yeah.
We're actually going to bake these pancakes. It's a great big, like, kind of, you can make them small and cute like they've got. You can make a big one and share it, like, brunch style. You know, brunch is one of my favorite things.
Yeah, me too.
It's a chance to get together. Like, you know, you have lunch, you have breakfast, you have all sorts of great stuff, sweet, savory. This is like a perfect dish to kind of bridge that.
It may not be traditional here in the States, but it is traditional in Germany. This is how they would make their pancakes in Germany.
Yeah, yes, all over like Germany, Holland, the Netherlands, all that's, they're baking pancakes. It's a beautiful, beautiful thing.
And it starts with a piping hot iron cast skillet.
Piping hot. So you want to preheat your oven, which we've got going, and I've got a cast iron skillet in there.
Okay, so that's important. That's
super important.
It's already
So we're not using a chemical leavening agent like when you make regular pancakes at home and you put baking powder or baking soda.
Right.
We're not using any of that. We're counting on the eggs to give it, like, to souffle up, basically, and give it that light, airy texture.
Wow.
So because of that, because we want it to souffle up and be light and airy and beautiful, we need a hot pan.
So otherwise it's not going to work.
Exactly.
So, over here, I know we have our dry ingredients, and while you mix those, this is just a basic.
This is super classic. Dry ingredients go into wet ingredients.
Yeah.
So if you ever see a recipe, you don't know what to do, just put all the wet stuff together, put all the dry stuff together, dry into wet, every time works.
And you're good to go. And as you mix that in, I'm noticing while I'm seeing everyone at the counter eat these pancakes, they remind me a little bit of a Dutch baby.
A Dutch baby. Right? Yeah. So, you know, the Dutch baby goes back about 100 years to the beginning of the last century. And the word on the street, at least what they teach you in culinary school, is that it was a restaurateur who, instead of calling it a baby German, he said a baby Deutsch, a Deutsch baby.
Which
and
Deutsch?
Somehow, over the last 100 years, that turned into a Dutch baby.
Because Deutsch means German in German.
So
exactly.
Funny.
My goodness, so it's not a Dutch.
It's not Dutch at all.
Pancake. It's a German pancake. Well, look at that. You learn something new every day.
So
does it matter if we're lumpy?
You know, I actually don't mind a couple little lumps in there. I think it makes it sort of fine. You don't want to overbeat it, right? You don't want it to be chewy and too, like, glutinous. You want it to just be nice and light and fluffy. So we've got our batter.
Okay.
It's room temperature. You know, if you're cooking at home, if it says room temperature, make sure it's room temperature. If it says melted, make sure it's melted. You don't want to cheat any of that stuff.
Okay, because that becomes science, and then it really does mess up the recipe.
Exactly.
Okay, this is piping hot. Careful.
Now, it has to be a cast iron pan?
Hold on a second,
I like
Aaron.
A cast iron pan.
Okay.
If you had something that was, you know, a similar shaped frying pan, that would be fine, too.
Okay, there you go.
We've got a cast iron. We're just going to put a little bit of butter in here and let it melt. That's going to make sure that it doesn't stick later.
Has anybody ever told you that you should do voiceovers?
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Voiceover work?
Or be on
a lot of people tell me. A lot of people tell me, but so far nobody who books voiceover talent has ever told me. So if you're out there,
there you go.
So we've got it nice and buttered.
Okay.
We're just gonna go ahead and add our batter. You wanna please do the honors.
Just pour it in,
all
just like that.
Pour it right in.
Wow, Cam, that's very satisfying.
This eating it is very satisfying.
Larissa and I are so happy right now.
There you go. We put some salt in there. Mix that around.
Wow.
So, I mean, imagine it's not too thick because it's going to puff up like a souffle.
No, exactly. It's going to be nice and light. And, I mean, you're eating it. You can tell.
It's thin.
But mine feels so thin. I don't know.
Okay. Yeah, so pop that in.
Well, it's got to go, right? We need to grab it from somewhere to go up the sides like that.
And how long does it go in for?
So it's going to go in for about 15 minutes.
Okay.
Then we're going to check on it and turn the heat down just a little bit. Let it go another 12 or 15 minutes. So it's about 30 minutes total.
Wow.
But, I mean, listen, you can have everything room temperature. Throw it in the oven when you're ready, and in 30 minutes, you got something great to go. So if you're entertaining, if you're chasing kids around, if
like
you're
it.
pouring yourself a mimosa at brunch, whatever whatever it is you're doing, this is for you.
Oh, look
what?
At that.
That's what I'm talking about.
Oh. So see, and I bet it's, you have a lot less chance of burning this one than you do the ones on the
Well, you definitely get a little more leeway, right? You get a little more leeway before it's ruined. Yeah. And listen, what I like to do is I like a little lemon and some berries. You can totally go any fruit, though, that makes sense. If it's fall, go apples and cinnamon. If it's, you know, somebody's birthday, go chocolate and pecan and caramel.
Gosh. Oh, yes.
Oh, my gosh.
You're speaking my language.
Apricots.
Sure. Wimbledon's coming up, strawberries and cream.
I can't believe it. It's so good.
Oh, could you make it savory?
Of course.
Can you imagine putting cheese on here? Oh, that would be so good.
I mean,
oh gosh!
All right, you guys
it doesn't
are
even need syrup, but why not?
Killing this over here. This looks amazing.
I win.
Now, while you're doing that, and I know you, Deb, you're going to start cutting it up and have a little taste. I want to say that it's brunch season over at Pancakes, right at your different Pancakes locations. So, what kind of fun stuff do you guys have planned?
You know,
for
great
this big season.
Great new menu. We've got these great cruller donuts that we make ice cream sandwiches with. We turn those into French toast at brunch. We've got the best fried chicken. We do chicken and waffles. All sorts of eggs and frittatas and Benedicts and. All sorts of great stuff.
Jeez, oh my gosh. Incredible.
If it's anything like this, we'll all be there.
I see you didn't like it at all.
No, I win. I finished
first. Go ahead and have a bite.
Look at that. It's piping hot. You see that?
Oh boy. Careful. Don't burn yourself. Is it perfect? Yeah, that's all you need to hear. That's all you need to hear. Aaron, perfect. As always, thank you. I'll have my agent call you about your future.